Hey OneStreamers, it's Ava back with an exciting new feature of OneStream Studio. Creating a professional intro for your OneStream Studio sessions is essential for a strong first impression. Similarly, a well-crafted outro, whether it be a call to action, a thank you, or a preview, leaves a lasting impression and keeps your viewers engaged and excited for the streams to come. So let us show you how to use these exciting intros and outros in your OneStream Studio sessions. Go to app.onestream.live and log into your OneStream Live account. Once you have successfully logged in, you can click on the Enter button under the Studio section and start a new studio session. In this onboarding window, you can check your video and audio connections, some other settings, add in a display name and a title if required, and then click on Enter Studio. Once you have successfully entered a studio session, you can click on the media option from the right side studio panel. Now, you will be given two options. The first one is to use a video clip, or the second one is to use an image. You have the option to use the videos that are pre-uploaded by OneStream Live or the images that are pre-uploaded by OneStream Live, or you can upload a custom video or a custom image by choosing this option right here and use that for your intros and outros. In order to choose a video or an image as an intro or outro, you would need to hover over that specific media file and click on these three dots. Now, choose your own preference whether you want to use this video as an intro or as an outro. For this purpose, we are just going to choose this video clip as an intro. You will be shown that this video clip has been chosen as an intro. Now, to set the duration of this intro, you would need to hover over the video file again and then click on this drop-down. Choose the duration that fits your own requirements, and remember, until or unless it is changed, the default time for your intro will remain 1 minute. In the similar way, we are just going to choose an outro, and you will be shown that your outro has been selected. Under the video clip section, you also get a volume controller. You can mute the volume of your video clips, or you can change the volume using this radar right here. However, it is to be noted that the images section does not have a volume radar. Once you have rechecked all the settings for your intros and outros, you can click on Go Live. Add in your title, your description, and the tags, and you will also be shown which intro you have selected that would play before the stream. You can select the social platforms that you intend to go live on and then click on Go Live. The intro will by default start playing before the stream starts. You can hover over the stream itself and you can click on Skip Now and the intro will be skipped. Now it's time for your outro. You can click on End Stream from the top right corner and your selected outro will be shown over here. If you want to unselect it and choose another outro, you can also do that. You need to click on End Stream button now. And your selected outro will start playing by default. In case you have uploaded a custom video or image as an intro or outro, and now you want to maybe free up some space, you simply need to hover over it and then click on these three dots and then you can click on delete. You can also rename this custom video or image. Another point to be noted is that the media files provided by OneStream Live cannot be renamed or deleted. And that was all about the intros and outros of OneStream Studio. Intros and outros are the final touches that transform your broadcast into a cohesive and memorable experience. So use this new feature and let OneStream Live take care of the rest.